Gentlemen, students, scholars, and crooks, you are about to graduate with the degree of MOCB, Master of Corruption in Business. And I want to give this last few tips to you before you go out into the unreal world and start your real business in the unreal world of honesty. What we need is a lot of dishonesty these days. The world can't progress unless it has dishonesty. Because unless you have dishonesty, how will you know what honesty is? And how will you know what is the thing that you've got to throw away, namely honesty? Okay, so here are the tips in business. No matter what happens, sell your product. Go and knock on a door. If that person refuses, go and knock on the door again. If he goes on refusing, you go on knocking on the door, right? Until he knocks you on the head, right? Go on knocking until he knocks you on the head. And then when he knocks you on the head, you go and knock on the door with your head, right? That'll mean another knock on the head, but at least the knock will be properly used in knocking the door, right? No losses in business. The other thing is, stick your foot inside the door if he opens it even 5 inches. Put your foot inside the door so he can't shut it, right? He'll say, "Who is it?" And when he opens the door 5 inches, put your foot into that 5 inches and jam your foot in there so he can't shut the door. And put your face inside that door and say, "Would you like to have a bag of peanuts made by the Peanutsia, our world peanut corporation?" Right? So remember these tips. And the third tip is this. When you sell something to your customer, tell him, no matter what happens, you will be there to repair it. Don't worry about the repair work. Let him but phone and you will come running. Right? And be very polite to him. For example, if his name is Mehta, Sahab is a word of respect, right? Sahab means like the British were Sahibs. So Sahib is a word of respect. So when you speak to somebody, like for example, you're speaking to Mr. Mehta. So you say, when you want to sell something to him, say very respectfully, "You see, Mehta Sahab, you see, don't worry about a thing going out of order. We are here, Mehta Sahab. We are your servants, Mehta Sahab. We are the servants of your servants, Mehta Sahab. We'll come running if anything goes wrong with the apparatus, right? We are here. Why else are we here, right?" And afterwards, when something goes wrong with the apparatus, he phones you once. You tell him, "Oh, we'll be there. Don't worry, we'll be there." You phone him and you don't go there, naturally, because you don't know anything about the product. You don't know whose product you have sold. You don't know whether it's yours or whether it's a theft, but you've sold something to him, right? You don't know who it belongs to. Then what you should do is, when he phones you again and again and again, then you switch off the mobile. And he'll keep on phoning you and he'll say, "Nobody's answering," right? He'll keep on doing that for a few months till he forgets about the whole thing and you forget about the whole thing, and then you go and sell another product to the same customer, or you go and he's forgotten about the first product, so you go and tell him, "Are you sure you don't want that same product again? Okay, boys, take your bags of peanuts, and be on your way. Good luck and happy hunting." Oh boy, this is my first business assignment. I better do good on this so that I can be granted a PhD, PhD in business corruption of business. Okay, here I go to sell this bag of peanuts. Hello, would you like to have this bag of peanuts made by the Peanutsia World Peanuts Company, sir? What? Stop knocking on the door. No, I don't want your peanuts. And I particularly hate the Peanutsia World Peanut Company. I took a bag of World Peanutsia Company and it gave me diarrhea. So get out. Don't even come to my door again. Understand? I don't want to see your face again. Okay, go. Excuse me. I'm knocking at the door again because I just wanted to be sure, you see? Sometimes we are not sure what we want. Maybe you already had the diarrhea. Maybe you've got chronic diarrhea since childhood. Why blame the peanuts, right? We have got to be absolutely sure that peanuts actually give constipation. They don't give diarrhea. You're misunderstanding something, right, sir? Peanuts, your world company, is the best world company in the whole world, right? What? Look, when I told you I don't want peanuts, why do you insist? I'm getting diarrhea just by looking at that bag of peanuts. And more so at your face. And I don't want you to go knocking at my door again. Understand? It can have some very terrible and tragic consequences. I don't want the MOCB candidates to lose one candidate. Right? So don't knock on my door again. Oh boy, this is a tough customer. But we have been taught in the MOCB courses that we are not to give up. We have to be persistent in business, right? You can't sell anything unless you're persistent. So let me knock on the door again. Sir, you must take peanuts. Doctor's orders. Because I'm a doctor. You see, I did my MD along with my MOCBD. And I can see from your face that you need peanuts in order to be cured of your disease, which is basically a mental disease which is giving you mental diarrhea, right? It's not physical diarrhea. So take physical peanuts to cure your mental diarrhea, right? How's that? Didn't I tell you that if you knocked on my door again and disturbed my peace of mind, I would make you go out of your mind? Didn't I tell you not to knock on my door again? Didn't I? Okay, then I will tell you in a different way. He's gone and closed the door again. But does that mean just because he's given me a punch on the jaw, does it mean I should stop selling him these peanuts? Well, no. Doesn't mean I should stop selling him the peanuts. I must be persistent. Right? I just came to make sure whether you really don't want peanuts, right? I just came to make sure. Are you sure you don't want peanuts? Right?